Good morning, dear students. Today we start our new chapter, inserting images, tables, and links in HTML. In previous chapter, we are knowing about the HTML. HTML is a language where we can create too many web pages using the HTML different tags. As far we have to move with the new tags or we can new elements to make up our web page more attractive and beautiful and meaningful according to the different tags. Inserting images. When by using too many web pages or visiting over there, we see there are too many images with the different kind of a matters or according to the links. Tables. In tables, we know that table is the area where we can put our data in a manner of rows and column. When we have this kind of a data, we have to create tables. And links. In HTML also belongs to links. Links that mean a link within another link. Most of the web pages are based on the different kind of a link. If we want to go to another link, it will open a new dialog for us. So, in this chapter, we are discussing about the image tags. Now, how it can be implemented within image tags? The simple tags that we have already done in the previous class, image tags must be included in the angle bracket. Then, SRC. SRC, that means is the source resource control, where we can give the location of the images, its own position. We call from this SRC tags an image, call the images .jpg or .png and different kind of a extension. Apart from the image, we can also manage with their heights, widths, align, and their border, and so on. We can, so in a just a simple manner, we can say that we also can manipulate or create images parameters. We can also adjust their height. Actually, in the web pages, there are too many small and big or different kind of images, heights, and their own widths. We can also manage with their heights. We can increase or reduce their height as well as its widths and their alignment. We know the alignment where we want to put images in our web pages as well as its border. So in this image tags, there are too many facets that we have. We have a text and we have just shown images related to the text, we can put images. And let's go on with the table tag. Table, as I mentioned earlier, table is a combination of rows and columns where we put our data in the manner of rows and columns. There are too many kind of a work. The data can be organized here in the manner of tables. So we can also create a table. And just simple, the tables are also converted into these tags and then brackets within a table. Then table also has their own related forms. There are rows, table data, its header, caption, etc. That which also is related to the table fields are rows. We know that the data is organized here in a row and column. How many rows or how many columns that we have in our table, we have to mention in that. Then data, where the data belongs to the table, we have also mentioned. Header, what is the table heading, and its caption, what kind of a caption we have to put within a table. It is we can also adjust their phone size, what is the cell space between the tables, their columns, their different kind of attributes. So we can also create a table. Then linking a web page using the anchor A tag, we have to link another web page. Within a web page, we can also create a we can also link a web page within anchor tag. Anchor tag is also belongs to URL, Uniform Resource Locator. This is the facility where we using or creating some HTML or internet based kind of work. URL, Uniform Resource Locator. These are the connectivity to connect the web page within a web page, and it is also converted within an anchor tag. So many of the web pages also be linked within a anchor tag based on our work. Like that, we have a simple kind of a work, and we have a different kind of work to related to show them in the new web pages. So we can create an anchor tag. Now creating email links. If we want to link our email, we also can create email links via URL. Absolute and relative references. There are some kind of a work where we show their related references or the absolute references through the tables or through the different kind of links. We can also create it or a link absolute and relative references. Creating bookmarks. Bookmarks also is the destination where we have to put in some marking option while we have a lot of kind of a work, or in case of a too many documentation kind of a work, we also create a or a link a bookmark for that. Images as a link. Images also can be created as a link. There are too many images that we use in web pages, we know that. So we have to also create images as a link. As a part of the web pages, we have to create different kind of a tag. It's as simple as that. We have to create in an angle bracket. We have to go through their text names. We have to just close with them. And it is also easy to knowing about the how it can be created. In our book, we have a multiple codings, and we have a related display or output of the web pages while we using this kind of a uses this kind of a link is shown in just in our book. So using this tag very carefully in the sense of with their tags, we have to close within the angle brackets and tie to some too many tags as an all in all. Starting from the previous chapter, I am telling about the HTML is a hypertext markup language. We have to create in our own tags, document, body, H1 to H6, their text attributes, paragraph, BR, there are so many tags. So using this tag, then also implement with these kind of a tags. All in all, if they are came together in the sense of our web page going to be the fulfilled in a manner. So in this chapter we have learned about the image, inserting image, tables and different kind of a links. So just try to get with your own coding through the books and try to implement in your at your home and found the output. So that is all for our chapter in this segment. In next chapter we will work on with more different tags or its attributes. Okay, thank you.